to be perfect. You get to create just what your mind go and it'll be great.
A good friend asked me the other day, if I was an art supply, what art supply would I be? And my answer was a Palmer Violet Prismacolor, because I think that is the art supply I use the very, very most. Prismacolor pencils are
magic wands. I adore my Prismacolors and can't leave the house without them. I'm going to take you on my last trip to Europe where I sketched with my coloured pencils. Usually you think of people sketching with pen or a graphite pencil. And even in my online classes, I encourage people, sometimes I boss them a little bit, to give up graphite, if only for a little while, and to try drawing with coloured pencil. Now, the reason people resist is because you can't erase coloured pencil very easily. And that's the whole point. You have to live with the lines that you create. And I think that that's a really powerful tool for you as an artist and for developing and sinking in and trusting your own skills. On the screen here, you can see how I'm drawing in an altered book. I'm just sketching over a page that already exists. It's that cute little face that I was so entranced with in a fountain in Bordeaux in France. I'm adding a little bit of optical blending. This is where I add light layers of different colours of pencils to create a third colour. And you can keep adding different light layers to make a lively, open background. And open means the paper can still peek through. It's a really nice way of creating a new colour rather than picking up a different colour all the time. You can use your pencils as crayons. Remember doing brass rubbings as a kid? I do them on streets whenever I'm traveling, especially manhole covers and things on the ground. There's always cool stuff around. Here I've created a sketch with a waterproof pen. I've added my Prismacolor pencil, coloured pencil, and then I'm using an alcohol marker blender, one of the colourless blenders. And that activates the waxes and oils in the coloured pencil and turns it into a paint. So you can get a watercolour-like effect. If you're using the right kind of pen, it won't move the pen. If there's watercolour under there, it won't move the watercolour. Alcohol and watercolour don't affect each other. And there's another brass rubbing where I've added my colourless blender around the outside to just make it integrate with the page a little bit more. And now I want to show you something else that's fun to do with coloured pencils. I adore drawing over matte paint. Matte craft paint is fabulous. Don't try this with a gloss, a semi-gloss paint, a normal acrylic. Has to be a matte or craft paint. So it's got that non-shiny surface. And the more tooth, the more texture, the more paint brush marks were visible, the more fun it is to actually draw on. You can erase your pencil once it's on acrylic paint or on gesso, but it can create a little bit of a film which becomes hard to draw on. Again, I think better to just leave your lines as they are. I think it adds to the artwork to see where the artwork has come from. Of course, that's just my personal aesthetic, but it's a fun thing to try for yourself and to loosen up and to relax and not put so much pressure on yourself, I think. Let those mistakes be visible, be part of the artwork. In this quick demonstration on screen, you can see how easy it is to, with just a few pencils, a few colours, and some acrylic paint, how nicely they go together and how quickly you can build up something that has meaning, that has visual interest, and that looks interesting and, most importantly, is fun to create. That's the thing about pencils that I love so much. They fit so well in the hand. They're so versatile, they're so receptive to a little bit of control. The what I'm going to show you next is a different type of blending. This is heavy blending, this is called, and it's where we actually apply pressure, which creates friction, which creates heat, and that actually melts the waxes and oils that bind the pencil pigments together and creates a painterly feeling. And it's just when all the colors start to smoosh together, beautiful. So I've started off with a light coating of a color called Deco Peach. It's just a nice light beigey color, pinky beigey color. I've added a color called Nectar just in the darkest parts of the face, across the eye, down under the nose. Then I added a little bit of lilac to have a little bit of a shadowed area in there, add a bit of variety. And I'm using dark umber to add some details. It's the way that these pencils layer and the way that they feel when I'm drawing with them and how responsive they are because of the amount of pigment that comes out with relatively little pressure that makes me adore them as a tool. And for example, in this girl that I'm drawing, I've got 4, 5, 6 layers of colored pencil, very, very light layers. And then I'm just building up. So now I'm adding quite a lively pink. I want the whole effect of this drawing in the end to be quite soft and porcelain-like. I want her to be a very, very fine and delicate looking skin. And you would think that bright pink and aqua and lilac in her skin colour would actually look quite odd and very, very bright. But once you see what I do next, you'll understand why I'm taking things a little bit far with the colour, because I'm going to use a layer of heavy blending to dampen those colours down, to integrate them, to activate and meld them together. So I'm pressing really quite hard with a color called Eggshell. It's an eggshell colored Prismacolor, and it's quite, it's like a very strong cream. And I'm using that on one side of the face so that it's warm, like a light is shining. So when you look at it in this form, looks kind of odd. You know, she's this yellowy colored skin with these bright, bright cheeks. That will all settle in with this blending. So now that surface is actually quite smooth and shiny, if I tip my paper, you'll actually be able to see a shine on it. It's actually making the paper pretty much waterproof as well, the paper underneath it, because I'm putting out this layer of wax. Now I'm using a white pencil, and I was just checking to make sure it was clean. Sometimes you can get little crumbs from the blending or left over from when you last used your pencils, or just when they were sitting in their container, they can rub and cross-contaminate. And if you had a little bit of indigo or a bright bit of pomegranate red on there, you would get a big smear of that colour across the cheek or something. So I just make sure I clean it. And again, I'm rubbing quite hard so that I physically am forcing the colors that are underneath to melt and blend into one another so that I get very, very, very soft and gradual transitions from one color to the next. But I can still see the shadow of those colors. And I can build up some really interesting skin tones. On the other side of the face, I'm going to do exactly the same process, but I'm going to use a different color on top to blend. I'm going to add more blush pink, more light peach, so that one side of the face is a different color to the other. That was my pencil just breaking. Prismacolors, because they're so soft, that can be a problem with them, is they can snap. So what I do is just put that little nub back in the pencil and just go for as long as I can before I have to sharpen my pencil again. Now that I've blended both sides of the face, I'm adding some highlights and I'll also add some details. Not all coloured pencils will allow you to keep adding all of these layers, then blend and then keep drawing on them. Eventually, you'll get such a waxy film that you just can't add anything else. But you can get two more layers out. One with your whitest whites. So I use a China marker because that will stick to just about anything. And you can use a China marker in black for your darkest areas. And that will stick to even the waxiest buildup of colored pencil. But I haven't really reached that point with this little sketch yet. I can still add pencil. I can still blend it in and just keep building and building so that my little face here just becomes smoother and smoother, and you can't see any of the paper underneath showing through at all. Of course, there's a limit to the amount of fine detail that I can get with my pencils. That's when I turn to pens and a very fine paintbrush if I need to add some tiny little bits and pieces. Because coloured pencils are one of the first things that we ever draw with as children, sometimes we tend to disregard them as something that we can use in our artwork. I want you to forget about that. I want you to embrace these incredibly versatile and fun tools. My intention with this art lesson is to get you to rediscover coloured pencils and embrace the fun that you can have with them and the amount of detail and feeling that they can bring to your artwork. If you want to learn more about the techniques that I've shown you and some other ones as well that I just didn't have time to show you, you can join me in one of my online workshops at janedavenport.com. Hope to see you there.